Hello everyone, and welcome to Ravnica Allegiance Premier Draft. And a pretty easy first pick. Ethereal Absolution is a pretty crazy card in this format. Not sure if it could be even the best card in the set, but anyway, it's gonna be the first pick always when you see it. Mm-hmm. There are some nice cards here. I guess if the rare was something bad, I might take the Sarctocrab, or I might just take the... Well, I don't know. Maybe it would be the Sarctocrab. I mean, there are the Cry of the Carnarium. This is best of one, so I think I like this more as a sideboard card. But yeah, might be the Sarctocrab that I would pick next, even though it's a two-color card. Anyway, very easy. Ethereal Absolution in here. I like this format somewhat more than I like the... Guilds of Ravnica. I think the guilds in this set have a bit more balance, so any of the five guilds is something I don't mind drafting. Whereas in Ravnica, Guilds of Ravnica, unless some guild is very open, you usually want to be like Boros or Dimir, because those have enough strong cards that it doesn't have to be super open in order to get a playable deck. How about here? I don't actually like these cards at all. I mean, these are pretty bad. I'm actually gonna take the guild gate. I don't really want to pick this second pick, but come on, this pack is really weak. I don't have to pick a black or white card here, but the Flames of the Raceboat, this is a 6 mana, deal 4 damage. It's not really good. This is very, takes a lot of mana, so I'm not a fan of that card. Slime Bind is like... Not an exciting card. I'll take the Guild Gate because I definitely want to at least splash this thing. Unless I'm going like Gruul or Simic in here, I will be able to at least splash the Ethereal Absolution, and this Guild Gate will help me in that process. Alright, so now we get actually good or so cards. The Vindictive Vampire is not a bad one, but I will take the Grasping Thrall. 5 mana, 3-3 flyer by itself isn't that great, but when you always get the Drain 2 here, it's absolutely a very good common. And I'm gonna pick it here. Okay, there's a Godless Shrine, but there's another... I mean, yeah, the Godless Shrine is, of course, slightly better than a Guild Gate, but not in that much better. I'm gonna take another Grasping Thrall. This kind of might seem like that the Orzhov is open. Of course, you can't play like a ton of 5-drops, but and the Blake White is definitely a good card as well. Good 2-drop, but still, I'm gonna take another Thrall here. I can play it. I mean, okay, I suppose I'm gonna get a ton of these Thralls here now. Which is of course fine, that means the Orzhov will be open, but I'm gonna take the Grotesque Demise here, because I mean, I have already two of these and this is the first pack, so I might be able to get more of these later in the draft, and even if I don't get, I'm happy to have two, and I can't really play like 4 or 5 5-drops in most decks. Anyway, this removal is a pretty easy pick here. And what do we have in here? This is more of a sideboard card and this is best of one, so I'm not gonna consider that. This is not really a good card. You have to sacrifice two creatures. So, I mean, I guess there's some kind of synergies in this set. Some death triggers or something that might make this card good, but I'm not gonna pick it here. I could just take the 4-drop. I mean, it's not the best, but the Scavenger is quite bad. It does work with some afterlife stuff, cheap afterlife stuff, but... How about the clear the stage? Target creature get -3/-3. Oh yeah, this requires really high power creatures. I'm not gonna take it. I'm just gonna take the Syndicate Messenger. Yeah, this is way too expensive for the effect. Unless you can guarantee the 4 power part of the effect. Right, Blood Mist Infiltrator. Sure, not gonna take it. Twilight Panther is actually, it may seem pretty kind of innocent, 1 mana 1/2, and this of course costs to activate the Death Touch, but it's something that Orzhov decks definitely like to have, because Orzhov decks usually are a bit grindy, and especially my deck has two decent flyers here that cost 5 mana, and also the Ethereal Absolution, so I want any kind of a cheap defensive card here, and then this Twilight Panther is quite nice. Right, I could take the Death Toucher, but I think I'm just gonna take another Guild Gate in here. I just like to have mana that works. It's also possible I get something like the uncommon, you know, this cycle where the mana cost is double for both colors, so you really want to have some mana fixing in that case. This consigned to the pit is like a 6 mana destroy creature. It's not really. I already have a bunch of expensive cards here. I mean, the question is between the Noxious Crudion and the Guild Gate, and I think at this stage in the draft I'd rather take the Guild Gate, and I'm fairly certain I get more of these Crudions. Like right just like just now I did get one of these Crudions. Consigned to the pit, still I'm not interested in it. I might pick one of them later in the draft, but I'm not really going to kind of pick them high. Alright, the Footlight Fiend. It's a card you can play. I mean, it blocks two toughness creatures nicely. It's pretty much all it does, unless you have some kind of synergies for it, but this deck doesn't mind to have a cheap card that can block opponent's early plays. It's not a bad card to main deck, and of course this is best of one, so you either main deck a card or you don't play it at all. Okay, so I have here a couple of lands and I have how many cards I really like to play. I mean, I guess I like to play. Maybe I don't have to play like them. Well, I don't know actually. I don't mind running on each of my cards, so I'm pretty happy about this pack one. Well, I take another Guild Gate. I guess there's a limit how many can you play. Well, now I'll take this. I could consider the Rakdos Guild Gate for some splashes, but I don't really like the splashing too much in here. I think the Orso will be open enough that I'll take this and maybe I play one of these. I don't have any other removal than the Grotesque Demise so far. But yeah, I guess there's an upper limit how many Guild Gates can you play, but I think I'm gonna always play like. This is pretty expensive. Afterlife 3 is okay, and the ability is, well, not the worst, but let's put it in here, but it's, well, possible I'm not gonna play it. Yeah, what I was gonna say. I'm gonna play 4 Guild Gates kind of always, but when it goes beyond 4, I might just have to kind of consider it that I do want to have a number of untapped lands in my deck too. It really can mess up your mana curve if you have like a, let's say 7 Guild Gates, especially in a 2-color deck, because a 2-color deck doesn't really need that many of those Guild Gates. If you play like a multiple colors, of course you must play more Guild Gates then as well. But in a 2-color deck, I think 4 might just be the maximum amount of Guild Gates. This Debtor's Transport is like a. I think it's a quite weak card. You could play this if you really don't have any high-end cards, but I already have so many high-end cards that it will be pretty unlikely that I would be playing that card. But it's in the deck now, but I will cut it once I'm beyond 23 non-land playables. Okay, so this is pretty bad pack for me. I mean, yeah, there's a Guild Gate, but I just don't know if that's something I want to have. This has Spectacle. This is a fine card, but I mean, I don't want to first pick it. Pegasus. Yeah, I don't care about this. You know what? I'm just gonna take the 20 gems in here because the packet just was not very unexciting to me. I'll take the small value in the 20 gems here. Okay, now we got the Orso Enforcer. It's a very nice card. Death Toucher with 2 mana Death Toucher with Afterlife. That's really a lot of stuff for 2 mana. This Thoroughbred Guardian is also an excellent card for whoever plays Simic or Gruul in this pod. Yep, there's no need to dwell that any further. Okay, we have a Consecrate Consume. So basically, it's a 2 mana cantrip if you need to just draw something. And then this is a good edict because the opponent, yeah, the opponent gets the choice, but they don't have. I mean, only if they have several guys with the same power. But this is a good edict. The Grasping Trull. I mean, I would run 3, but I suppose I'll just take the Consecrate Consume. The edict is quite nice against Gruul and Simic decks that can have some very big high power creatures. Yep. And it always has the 2 mana option if you are like you don't find a good spot to use 4 mana on this kind of effect, then you can just cycle this for 2 mana. because some graveyard will have a card at some point anyway. And I guess this can also occasionally fool opponents' race dead plans. This format has a few cards that return creatures from graveyard. So this could be a good response in that case too. Alright, this Embrace, yeah, this is a bad edict. So this is a 3-mana edict where opponent gets to, you know, pick their weakest card and sacrifice that. So definitely not what I'm looking for here. And I'm gonna just take another Twilight Panther here. I think it's pretty easy. The Tithe is not really a limited playable card. You don't need mana that much in most decks. Okay, so really not that good cards in here. This is Civic and Gruul will have targets, Rakdos and also an Azorius not so much. That's too often going to be a dead card, so I'm not gonna play it. This is a 4-mana 2/3 flyer, can gain some life. More like a sideboard card to me. I'm gonna actually just take the Guildgate now. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get more than 4 Guildgates anyway, but I just wasn't interested in the... I already have a 4-mana 2/3 flyer, and this has a more relevant ability than the black one had. Okay, a Green Drafter gets a... I think this is a quite nice card, especially if you have other counters already, and of course Gruul has a Riot and Simic has Adapt, so both green card guilds in here will have counters very easily. I'll just take another Noxious Grudon here. I do need cheap cards here still. Alright, so Carnival is something I could play. It's a weak effect though, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna pick the Guildgate. I usually don't like lockets, but now that I have a pretty bunch of, you know, these expensive cards, I mean, a turn 3 locket into a turn 4 Grasping Truly, it doesn't seem that bad of an idea. And out of these cards, I think it's just the best. I don't really want to pick the fourth, the Guildgate beyond the fourth one very highly at all. Okay, so this thing is your very standard 3-drop, 3-mana 3/2 with a small upside. Is Blade Brand gonna be better? I don't think so necessarily. I have some Death Touchers here already. Yeah, I have actually quite a few Death Touchers. I mean, in fact, 5. Death Touchers, so I'm just gonna take the Officer if I need a 3-drop here in my eventual deck. Yeah, well, we got the Dead Rebels, sorry. Again, another Food Light Fiend. I'm not gonna take another one of these. The Pegasus, I mean, I don't have really 2-drops other than the also Enforcer, and this does block some small flyers, and well, it can also deal some damage to the opponent. I suppose at this point I'm just wanting to take the creature and a 2-drop. But it's not a very... I mean, I'm not excited to play this card. Right, there's nothing for me here. And, well, there's the Blood Mist Infiltrator. I'm not gonna play it, though. Wow, the Get the Point is still in here. Well, I suppose I'm not gonna splash a 5-mana card. I have 5-mana cards here already. Yeah, these are not gonna be best of one playables at all. Bring the Trial. Well, we don't play two of these guys, so I guess I can take it. But I'm not gonna play it. I have 4 lands in here, so 18 out of 40 cards, so I need 5 playables here. I might play the Knight of Last Breath now that I got the Ors of Locket. Might be something I can consider. I guess this trick is consider something you can also consider. Okay, Arcway Angel. Oh, these are pretty bad ones. I mean, 6 mana 3/4 flyer that will gain quite often 2 life and sometimes 4 life. But my expensive cards, I have enough of them. I don't need any of them. I mean, either I take another Panther. No, I'm just gonna take 20 gems. I'm gonna be rare here. I'm gonna be rare drafting and be greedy here. That's what I was trying to say. Because I'm definitely... I don't want to have a 6-drop here. I just want cheap cards. And now it's actually a question between the another Grotesque Demise. But I think the Oligarch is just so much better. Even though this might have a slight chance to come back to me at pick 10, but I want to pick this this one. It's a very good 2-drop for the Ossof deck, and I still need 2-drops here, definitely. And now I get... Okay, well, I'm happy I get a lot of options, but it's kind of sad that they are all in the same pack. I mean, even this one is pretty nice, because this can surprise block a 4 toughness creature and trade with it. This is better than your average 3 mana 2-1 flyer. And then there's a Ministrant of Obligation, which is great. Grotesque Demise again, and then Tithe Taker. I guess I'll take the 2-drop, and I suppose the fact it has 20 gems. Well, I don't think it matters that much, because I want to have more 2-drops and the 3-drops, and I currently have equal amount of them both. So I'll take the 2-drop here. Okay, so still we have good options. I could take the Orator, some life gain here, because I mostly just need to... Well, I don't know. Well, I have some late game cards that I just need to survive here. So the question is, do I want to have this Plague White? But this is not so aggressive deck. This ability only works when it attacks. So I'll try to take the 2-2 that can gain me some life while I'm actually waiting more to get enough mana to play my expensive stuff. Right, so Carrion Imp versus Viscopa Vampire, neither of which is very good. I guess I haven't picked any other 4-drops here, so I'm gonna take the Carrion Imp now. But a 4-mana 2-3 flyer is just it's just bad against some gruel when they play, you know, 4-mana 4-4s and stuff like that, so this doesn't do much against them. But I suppose I have a couple of Death Touchers here against a gruel, so I should have that matchup in some kind of, somehow in control. Okay, this Rampaging Rendhorn is quite nice card for green decks as well. Here we just don't have anything I'm interested in. Screaming Shield, yeah, the mill win condition. Come on, not gonna play anything here. I have enough playables already, so I'll just take some. Don't care about it, just something. Not gonna play any of them. Well, Naxxus Grudion, it's gonna be here the choice. So now even more Death Touchers against some. Decks which have big guys. I guess I'll take the Senate Griffin here. It's a double caster in this color combination, but I still need to have a 4-drop. And even though 4-mana 3-2 flyer isn't nowadays that great, the Scry one helps a bit here, so I'd rather have it than many of these other. I don't need the Guildgate or the other creatures there. And well, I can take now my third Twilight Panther, and I'm still not interested in the Scavenger. Now. Wow, this came back. I mean, that was probably my second choice, or at least third choice in the pack, but I'm happy that the pack that had a lot of cards for me. Or was it even the same pack? Because this pack, where the Spy Mangler was, that was a strong pack, but I'm super happy to get it because I wanted to pick both the Demise and this thing. Yeah, I suppose in these, I actually might even take the Caracal rather than this 2-1, because I'm more interested in blockers maybe than attackers. I should have the late game in a pretty decent shape here, but I do have a lot of cards to cut here, but at least I got now a decent amount of options, so my mana curve will, for example, look quite nice, I think. Okay, Thurston, say none of these matters, I'm not gonna play any of them. Yeah. So if you are not familiar with my channel, I do upload daily draft content and occasionally maybe some strategy content and absolutely limited set reviews as well. For example, when Kaldheim releases, I will be posting uploading a limited set review right when the full spoiler is available. Oh, well, maybe not right, but very soon after that. So please consider subscribing if you are interested in this kind of content. Okay, so these are not gonna be in the deck, so I'll just check out now. Maybe I'll cut the basics for now, but I have to figure out if I want to, you know, play a lot more of some other color. But I guess it's very even black-white, so I probably will play pretty even. I mean, I will play 17 lands and most likely... Well, I will see. I will have one more of the other land than because there will be 13 basics, so it's gonna be 7 and 6. But I don't yet know which I want to have at 7 copies. Right. So easy cuts are Food Line Feed, because I got this Panthers in triples, and I also got a bunch of 2-drops. The Zeal is not very good, and let's say this is like a 4-drop usually. Debtor's Transport is not needed. I'd rather play the Consigned to the Pit than the Debtor's Transport, and I still have a lot of expensive cards. Although, that's only 2 5-drops, 6-drops, 6-drops, 7-drops. Yeah, that is a lot of good expensive cards, I have to say. It's 4 lands, so 26 cards. I need to cut 3 more. And is there something I want to cut in here? I have now 3 1-drops and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 2-drops, so I guess I will cut the... I mean, the Pegasus or the Caracal, both have some uses. I know I'm not going to play the Haste Officer. I have now 3-drops. I have 4 3-drop creatures, and then removal and the Locket. I think in this deck I will play the Locket because of the amount of these expensive cards in here. I don't really feel like cutting any of these 4-drops or these 5-drops. I guess the only consideration here is to, I mean, cut the Knight of the Last Breath, or perhaps the Consigned to the Pit. But I think I have so many Death Touchers that I should be able to delay the game enough that I get to access to these expensive cards, because I can just trade with Ground Guys, and I don't think there's that many aggressive flyer decks in this format. Even Azorius doesn't have like a very aggressive flyers. And I at least have the couple of Grotesk Demise, and I have this Spire Mangler to deal with flyers. And I guess that's a reason to play the Concordia Pegasus and not play the Caracal, because this can block some flyers. Alright, so I still need to cut one card. Right, so... yeah, I don't think... I will leave the expensive cards in here, but does that mean that I have to cut one of these cheap cards still? Maybe like one Panther? It might be a bit overkill to play three of them when I also have three Noxus Grudions. Yeah, I can cut one Panther. I'd rather have the Pegasus perhaps, because this can also, you know, attack over the opponent if there's some kind of ground style. If I have all my Death Touchers ready to block opponent and they don't want to attack with their big guys to my Death Touchers, then I can use the Pegasus to deal the occasional damage here. So yeah, this is the deck, and let's see the colors, 13 and 15. So maybe the tiebreaker here is probably the Senate Griffin. It's a double caster, but then again, these require black as an activation, so I need to consider the possibility that I want to activate this on some turn and play a black spells on that same turn. For example, turn 4. Play one of these 3 mana black cards and also activate the Death Touch, so maybe... yeah, this is the only thing that actually makes me want to have a double white available. All other stuff kind of don't need it, so I guess I'll still play... well, I have 2 more black cards also, so that could be some kind of tiebreaker. Anyway, with these Guild Gates and the Locket, I don't think hitting the double white is gonna be a problem, so I'm gonna play 7 Swamps here. 7 Swamps and 6 Plains here. And that's the deck. Let's go and see how the games go. Pretty nice mana curve actually. 17 creatures, 6 non-creatures. Not that much removal, but the Death Touchers are kind of semi-removal because they make sure that the opponent can't easily connect with their Ground Guys. Well, I'm on the draw with a 4-drop as my first play. That's too risky. Yeah, the mana is nice, but I'm gonna mulligan this. I need some cheap cards, and this is a much better hand, but also it's a hand that has a pretty difficult decision about regarding what do you lose in here. Both of these 2-drops are good, and the demise is good too. This will draw eventually me more cards, but I guess I just want to maintain my curve out and have the first removal. Yeah, I'm gonna lose the Locket in here. I don't wanna cut a land and be punished by not drawing many lands here. I do have also a lot of expensive cards in here. I suppose one consideration to keep the Locket was that it's basically a land, and if I draw any land in here, then it's maybe better to have the card that is able to draw me two cards at some point in the game. But like, I guess it was like safer to keep the three lands in here. And now I did draw a three drop. So for example, if I don't draw a land here, well, I did. So I guess if I knew this, I might have lost the land and kept the locket. I think I'm gonna just take a two drop guy here. I mean, the two power guy, I have two drops here, but the two power guy has some chance to deal some more damage if they don't really have a good blocker. The 1-2 Death Toucher is good at blocking, but not so good at attacking. Okay, three colors. Drill bit. They get to. I don't care actually. My hand doesn't have anything exciting, and I will have a play for next turn regardless, so. I suppose they take the removal if they have a good target for it. Yeah. Otherwise. Well, at least I drew another removal here. So. Orso and Rakdos combined. Let's see what that means. Okay, I got my. Oh no, that's Exile, yeah. Kind of forgot. This is not Vanquish the Weak, that's in Zendikar Rising. It is exactly an Exiler, so that means the Afterlife won't trigger. Yeah, I'm too used to Vanquish the Weak. Well, at least I have mana here now to. Okay, now they chose to exile that guy. They could have also exiled this, you know, the guy with the afterlife. So they are like a removal special here. I did draw a very nice card here though. Let's see if they have yet another removal. But yeah, I am not. I am now at five lands. Okay, they do. They do have all the removal there. Let's see who is gonna. Yeah, it's pretty annoying because. Even if I kill it, they get two flyers there. Well, I suppose I'm gonna just leave my guy to a block. I'd rather, you know, block with the 1-2 than the 2-2 here. What would they have? Well, I can kill that with the consign to the pit at some point. Let's just kill it and start attacking with my flyer, and let's see if they have some kind of a solution here. Well, they have something, but they are figuring out if they want to cast it. Okay, they get to remove that. Oh, that's fine. Okay, they can trade, but I get the 1-1 in here, so it's a pretty even situation, because if they attack with the Debtor's Transport, then I can block it. They get 2-1-1 flyers, and I will have 2-1-1 flyers. So it's completely about which one draws better cards. I guess I have the Ethereal Absolution, so that's gonna be a very, very strong draw that I can have. So now our, yep, it's completely now about who draws better. That's fine. They get to have a 5/5, and they get to scry 2. One top, and I get to land here. So, yeah, they with this scavenger, they are in a better shape than I am. But of course, if I draw the Ethereal Absolution, that will still win the game. I mean, the 5/5 is gonna be a problem though, but I have a lot of Death Touchers. I have two of those Panthers, and I have. Oh, that's. Okay, well, opponent did draw very good. Alright, I guess that's enough. I drew just land when they. I mean, they did get the Scry for 2, so there's no. That's no wonder they got to draw a good card there, but they were really able to remove all my guys that had some threat value, and then they were able to continue with the gas, so. No win there for me. Because certainly even Ethereal Absolution was too little too late, because they were able to play so good, guys. Yeah, this is a keep. I only have a 3 mana play here, but if they have a, well, I can potentially play the turn 4 Thrall here, yeah, but of course it might just be so that I'm gonna use the Demise on turn 3 instead. The opponent did mulligan to 6 though, kept 6. Okay, that's fine, they get to... Now if they want to, they can leave a creature or land. Alright, I get the 2 drop here, well that's nice. So if there's nothing too threatening in there. 3 colors. Do I want to lose my orator? I mean, I could. It's just a 2-2. I mean, yeah, it's gonna gain me some life, but I suppose I can just make the trade here. Because I do want to play the Locket next turn instead of... Well, I can't even demise that thing. So, okay, it's a... Well, I mean, I suppose the orator would have been a lot better blocker against this. I can't imagine they're starting to use the 4 mana activation quite yet, so... That was an awkward 3 drop for them. Okay, well, I mean... I guess I lose this game as well. Oh boy. This is pretty insane. Right. Well, but this is gonna give plus 2 plus... Oh yeah, well, I'm gonna just try to trade with it. So they unless they have... Well, of course they can have something, and that's just a, you know... They have the perfect draw there. Yeah. I'm gonna take here 10 damage now. I'm at 4, so I can't even demise the Beastmaster there, because... Well, okay, that's good, but I can't activate the Death Touch. So actually... Yeah, but they can fly with this thing. Well, that's the reason I have to play the Thrall here. Rather than the Panther and the Demise here. Okay. Can't do much about it. So hopefully they don't have another, you know, thing. If they do, then I just lose, but I mean, this is such a good 4 drop when they you have to board advantage. Well, I mean, I can block the Huntmaster, eat it, and then jump block the Creeper, but because I have the Grotesque Demise, I'll just rather do like this. I can kill the Beastmaster anyway. And hopefully they don't have anything to... That has Trample. So they can make this a 7 power Trample round, I will just lose, even if I kill this thing. So, that was a pretty nice set of draws from the opponent. They even had the blue mana to threaten for the flying activation, so I couldn't go with the Panther demise plan for the previous turn. I mean, I think my deck is quite fine, but those draws the opponents have had, they have been just, you know, pretty good draws. Good tempo and good answers to my stuff here. I mean, I guess in that game that showed how the Locket can be bad if you use your turn 3 to play a Locket and the opponent had the Hasty guy there. If I had... Oh, sadly I don't have... Let's see, I have 11 black sources in the deck. None of them in my starting hand. So I have to mulligan this. Oh, come on. Well, at least now I have white cards to cast, but that's pretty weird. I have 11 black cards. Anyway, I played the Locket there, and the opponent played something that affects the board, and it was even the Hasty guy. So, pretty good one. So, that's the bad part of the Lockets. I'm not gonna trade that one. I have the Pegasus in here. Okay, so not... Tithetaker... No, Concordia Pegasus is good, and Twilight Panther is good. Well, this just could be an 0-3 now, because I did mulligan here and the opponent was on the draw, so that means they have more cards available and they don't have any bad cards here, so... Wow. Alright then. Yeah, I mean, that's a pretty nice curve from there, and I of course drew a 6 drop I can't play in ages. Yeah, well, this is gonna be on 0-3. Most likely. Okay, they have something. So this thing can get Death Touch and indestructible when they sack something, so I suppose. I mean, they are gonna have something here. I just have to figure out what do I want to do. I guess I can do it like this. And I can do it like this. I don't know. Don't even remember all the tricks in this format, but I'll just make this and see what happens. Okay, so just trade with the Panther with the... Okay, these are all trades. Okay, I suppose they have their, you know, their dead rebel, or what's the return to? Oh, they have that. Right, we'll consign to the pit. Bye-bye. Yeah, this hand is... Alright, I mulligan this thing. I have 11 black sources in the deck. I suppose I take the damage here. Maybe I draw a swamp and I can play the enforcer here. Well, I can block that thing. Well, that's not a swamp, but it's still a good one. So now I can just cast the enforcer to block the Bellhound. That is a free block here. I mean, they had a free attack there, so... Oh, and they have that. Right. Okay. I have the Death Toucher now, but do I want to play just my flyer? This says that... Okay, it taps something, but that... Well, that doesn't tap anything from me, but it can deal a 2 a turn, so that's... That's a problematic thing, actually. I wonder why they attacked with the Messenger. Maybe they want me to attack with my Spirit Token. I mean, it can block the Oligarch, but so does the Pegasus. Maybe they shouldn't have attacked with this. Now I'm just have to decide which of these is gonna be the better one. Can I take another 3 here from the Bellhounds? This Dusk used 5 mana, so they can't do that much else. I don't know, it's an interesting question. Of course, because this uses all 1 mana, but if my next draw is like a land, then it doesn't matter at all. But I do care about... Maybe, well, I'm gonna attack with this 1-1 regardless. Yeah, that's like a, gonna happen either way. And I suppose if I leave the Pegasus to block, I'm gonna play the Oath of Enforcer here. I don't wanna take damage from the Bellhound. I guess I can leave the land in my hand if they have another way to, for me to discard a card. Don't actually remember if this format has a discard 2 card. Hopefully not. So it's gonna be a Death Syndicate. Well, I do have the Trull in here, so it can connect. None of these. Yeah, okay. So they're gonna deal 2 to me each turn when they don't have any other play here. But I guess I have the life gain here. I have some other life gain here too. I can, with the Cadonimba, I can take the. Yeah, I can take them. creature card from their graveyard. So I mean, I'm actually winning this race if they don't draw anything super good in here. So that's pretty sweet. Hopefully they can't dance with that Thrall, because this will win the game eventually in this board position. That gives me life, and this will give me 2+1 life, so the guild mage isn't that relevant in here now. Get rid of the Pontiff, because they might have the double raise dead effect. Also, it's quite sad that I haven't seen my pack one peak one even once in the game, so I would like to play in this event until I actually get to. I have to now figure out something. I could attack with more than... Okay, I could attack with three flyers, but they can only take one extra damage, and then they can deal with damage with this, so... Is it, like, worth it? I mean, trading one damage to... But if they attack with this, then my counter-attack will be a lot larger, so actually I'm gonna do it. I am going to do it now. Because if they attack with the Syndicate Messenger, it doesn't have Vigilance, then I can attack with the, you know, 6 or no, 7 damage in the air, so they probably aren't even going to attack. So this makes sense. Dealing one extra damage here. And I suppose I play my land just in case they have a discard effect, and if I draw the Ethereal Absolution. In that case, if I had to discard the Plains, Army the Swamp, that would be just horrible. Okay, I have to sacrifice. They don't get to gain life. Yeah, I will sacrifice one of my things. And is it gonna be like the... It might just be the 1-1 flyer. It doesn't do anything as long as they have the Syndicate Messenger. They can attack with the Oligarch now, by the way. That is something. But I guess... yeah. Let me see. I mean, I don't wanna... But the Enforcer is... Well, I guess the Twilight Panther is gonna block the Bell Haunt here. Could just, you know, sack the Enforcer. Although if they have some removal for this thing, it might be somewhat awkward. I could just sack the 1-1 token here. It's not so easy decision, actually. Not easy at all. Fine, let's take the Enforcer. I get at least one extra life thanks to the Operator here. Okay, that doesn't do much. And they can't attack with the Messenger, they can't really take 6 damage from... Yeah, I will take this 1 damage. I don't want to give them any 1-1 flyers. The moment they get the 1-1 flyer, they can double block the Thrall, and that's very bad for me. So I'm gonna just continue with the same plan. I almost could attack with the 1-1s too, but maybe not yet this turn. Maybe it's gonna be something I do on the following turn. They get to eat one of these 1-1s, although they would take damage. In that case, they would take... Okay, that's quite a lot of damage, and I have 15 life here. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna actually do this, because now they can't block the 2-3 if they are gonna eat one of my guys. So actually, this is going to mean a win for the next turn. Yeah, so definitely that was worth it, because, I mean, they could just draw land and that's win for me then. They actually have to draw something very relevant now. They don't have enough power in the ground. Okay, they can draw for 2 cards, but then they will have only 1 mana available. If one of their cards is a land, they can play a 2 mana spell, so it doesn't seem like it's gonna work here. Yeah, no blocks there. Well, still don't have the absolution, but it seems like I can win this game unless they have something really. Yeah. Okay, well, it wasn't an 0-3 after all. I get the crown stall and then my flyers did the job. Well, I mean, I guess I go 7 wins now. I'm on the draw, but yeah, this hand is a keep, because I have the Death Thatcher here, and this is a Death Thatcher too, so I mean, okay, this is something I did not want to draw. Do I want to play the Guild Gate? I guess I'll play the 1-2, maybe it can connect once or twice here. Anyway, If I get the third land, I can play this, and then it's only one land more, and I can play the Griffin. This has Scry. This I can use to draw a card, because at some point a graveyard will have a card, but that was... Well, I mean, I suppose the Grudion isn't that bad. Because now if I draw the third land, I have a lot of plays to make here. Okay, that's good. So, maybe I want to try to connect here. I'm not in a... Of course I don't want that the opponent blocks, but I don't think they will. Okay, well they did. I mean, of course they don't know that I have... They don't know that I have Grudions of my own. Maybe they have something that they wanted to just get rid of the Death Toucher. Consume. I'm gonna leave the consume here. I'm not gonna draw a card now. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. I get a life. Yeah, sure. So now, okay, I guess it's not bad because last turn if I played the Grudion, I would have played another Grudion now. Now they can have removal for this and deal 5. So that was maybe a bit too risky. I was just, you know, connecting for 1 damage and I tried to kind of min-max. I didn't really think that they're gonna block it, but they were, so... Now it doesn't matter if they don't have a removal because this has Death Touch and a boost spell doesn't help. But if they have a removal, I will take 5 damage here and like this. Now I hope I draw the land because I just want to use the Consecrate Consume here. Okay, I mean, this is gonna be bad if they have like multiple removals and the only reason this happened because I wasted my turn, their turn when I could have played this, but I had to use one of my mana for the activation of the Death Touch. So that's my greediness and I'm not gonna, I mean I didn't expect them to play a 4-drop, 4-power guy here. So this was the worst possible scenario. Had I just played the Grudion, they couldn't have. Yeah, I mean, which it's my fault, of course. Yeah, not the Electro Dominance here. Just come on, let's draw the land, please. Okay, good. Get the life back, at least a bit. I mean, I guess they did use some removal on my 2/2s, although the Death Touchers are quite good. But yeah, things are fine now, things are fine. But yeah, I could have gotten a little bit better start in this game if I didn't attack with the 1/2 on that one turn. Well, maybe I should be more careful in future in such situations. I mean, the only benefit for me in that situation was that if they don't block, I get to deal 1 damage. So that's really not so great. Okay, now it's time to play the Scry thing. None of this flies, so I will play the Scryer for now. I will have a land on my top. Okay, that's kind of a bit too late. But I still keep it because, I mean, it's a 2/3 flyer, can gain me life and can block the 5/2. Yeah, I don't need to land right away. I can have the Twilight Panther and Grotesque Demise. Okay, do I have something here? Yeah, but I don't have anything that returns creature cards. So I can just offer the trade here. I mean, I don't have to. But yeah, I will have another flyer, so I'm gonna offer the trade here. And probably just... Probably just then, you know, play my own Carrion Imp here. Get rid of this before they can return it with something. So they are missing their fifth land drop, so we both have a lot of spells, so this can be an interesting game. But I really want to draw at least once this, you know, there. Can I please draw once the Ethereal Absolution? That's such a sick card. Would be fun to play with once. I mean, of course, it's not fun for the opponent. All right, I have to now decide. Do I want to now deal 2 damage or do I risk taking 5 again because I will be a greedy guy? I guess this time I'm not gonna risk it. I'm gonna have 2 blockers for the guy, and I won't deal 2 here now. I guess I just want the game to go long, just because I do have the Ethereal Absolution, and that's gonna win the game if I draw it. Even our Rakdos, those colors don't have enchantment removal. So maybe I'll just, you know, get the 1/1 flyer here. Let's see what they have. interesting choice that they did. Okay, now I got the Absolution. But yeah, I don't necessarily agree with their decision to play the Grotesque Demise like that. I mean, of course they wouldn't have attacked if they don't want to trade with the Imp here. Okay, I'm not gonna attack. Now I'm taking this. Because now that I have the Absolution, all I need here is to draw the sixth land. I can demise that. Okay, that kind of eats one thing too, that I could hit with the Absolution, but I will have creature cards in the graveyard in anyway. Perhaps, do I? There's like one in here. Okay, I'm gonna use the demise just. And that's gonna exile, doesn't even. Okay, fine. No. So, okay, now I have two blockers for that thing, so I'm gonna actually attack. I wish they don't have any kind of discard effect in here before I get to draw the sixth land here. I'm also pretty worried because they have missed the fifth land drop all the time, so they have seven spells in their hand. That can be very bad. Of course, the Ethereal Absolution will be a good one here, but still, it could be problematic. Yeah, I mean, this passive effect basically means that the opponent's afterlife does nothing, so that's pretty sweet. I just want that sixth land gets drawn here. Thank you. So now I can. This will be a 2-1, this will be a 4-1. I will leave these 10 guys to block. Won't have mana to. Well, I mean, they don't need a death touch because this will be one toughness only, and this is gonna be a 2-3, this will be a 3-3. So, I'm just gonna jam the Absolution here, and now the opponent will not like this situation at all. So, do they have a creature card? Because this works so that it can exile anything from graveyard, but only if it's a creature card, it will create me a token. And of course, because of the passive effect, it will in fact be a 2-2. And Gragdos colors cannot deal with the enchantment. In Ravnica Allegiance, black didn't have enchantment removal in the color pie. I think it was the Theros. Was it Theros or was it like... I don't recall if it was the... Maybe it was Theros Beyond Death, which was the first set where there was the Farika's Libation or something that made black be able to get rid of enchantments. Yeah, that was like the reasonable play to make, because this is such a... I mean, this is probably the best... Yeah, I think if I recall correctly, this is the best card in the set. Especially as a pack one, pick one, you don't have to have any color considerations. Yeah, this is a sick, sick card. Well, I won one game because of it, so that's basically the all I wanted here now after having such a bad start. And I guess I did start 0-2 and I'm 2-2. I suppose the ideal point would be to get the third win because that's like 750 gems. The next win is worth 750 gems, which is worth more than any other win in this event, so let's try to get it. But I mean, I got my Absolution on the battlefield once, so it's not so bad. Now I go first this time again, just two lands, but I do have I can play all the rest of my cards if I draw the third land, so I don't really see how I can mulligan this hand ever. 0-3. Well, I did draw another 3 drop. So, I also have a 3 guild gate, so I might draw a land that enters tapped. Okay, well, that was the best possible draw. So, this makes mana if they have other untapped creatures. Okay. So, I'm gonna play the Death Toucher because I can actually start raising here. This can. Well, they can't, you know. They have to trade if they are gonna attack, block this, unless they have a first striker, but we'll see if they have. Yeah, now that I did draw the third land in time, this seems like a pretty decent game here for my, at least I don't have mana issues now. I have 4 spells I can play on my next 4 turns. Okay, still no play from the opponent. This doesn't make any mana by itself. So I'm just going to attack with them both and see what's gonna happen. I don't know what they're doing. They have both colors, 3 mana. Or are they playing like a... Maybe they are playing like a... More than 2 colors, that would explain this thing, of course. Okay, next, if I can draw yet another land... Okay, that's fine. If I can draw yet another land, I can actually go lock it into demise. Although, it might still be a guild gate, which wouldn't allow me to do that. So, will there be a play on turn 4? Okay, this is... A non-token creature enters the battlefield. If it doesn't have the same name... Okay, they're gonna draw a bunch of cards here. Because I suppose most of their cards are some cards that the creatures are that, such that they qualify for this. But at least now that I did get the Enforcer, I can play nicely. Lock it into Enforcer. I have now 5 power of death touch and I have a couple of grotesque demises. This one will draw me cards. So I don't really, even though they get to draw cards here, I mean, I suppose... That's the first card, so I mean, it's a 4 mana card, so it kind of have to draw 2 cards to be worth it. Well, that's the good, they're already there, so that's the 2. So, I mean, any other cards they draw will be very good. But I mean, I have a good turn because I have Demise and I drew a 2-drop, so I can get rid of this only untapped creature they have. And I can play that Oligarch, I can deal 5 damage to them and they will be at 7. And then I still have all these death touchers and the Enforcer even will be creating a 1-1 flyer for me, which is gonna be relevant because Gruul doesn't have that many ways to deal with flyers unless they use removal for it, of course. And they are only at 7 life here. Okay, well that's conveniently something I can get rid of with the Demise. But I still will trade... One of these will trade, but at least when I get to demise this thing, my oligarch can attack. Okay, so this is actually good. Now that I play this, they might have something that costs 2 mana. Okay, I guess they have this thing still, but I mean, no reason not to play it right away. It's not like this, they have a 4 spike or anything there waiting for me. For my grotesque demise. So they did have a... spell, but then now this is gonna be amazing. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Unless they have 1 mana boost spell. They did it. So this was pretty sweet. Attack with all. They can of course block with the caretaker, but they still take here that much damage and I do have flyers. I have the couple of these flyers that even drain some life from there. Yeah, I am in a good shape here because, yeah, I have death. This doesn't have trample, no, so I can, you know, they are not gonna win the game in any time soon. So I still have these death touchers, which means, I mean, I guess I could attack with everyone in here and get the 1-1 flyers, which might be good here, but I mean, first things first, I'm gonna... Yeah, play the land and draw the cards. Let's leave the gate here. Okay, well that's the flyer there. So let's say if I attack with everyone, they're gonna use the caretaker to block one of these 2-1s, and they're gonna take the Oath of Enforcer through. They're gonna trade with the Grudian with the boar, and this is gonna eat one of my 2-1s here. That does mean, though, that next turn... Yeah, it's not so easy decision, because this Enforcer is also pretty good. I mean, I suppose this... Yeah, they will take the Enforcer through. They will trade with the Grudian with this boar, and they will block both of my 2-1s, and one of them will die. And this oligarch will die, because this has Vigilance, so it could block. I mean, I can take the... This is more like, do I want to have the 1-1 flyer for next turn? Because if I can have the 1-1 flyer, then I can attack them because they will drop to 3. And then I can, attack with the 1-1 flyer. they will drop the two, and then the Grasping Drool will be lethal. So is it worth sacrificing one of my two ones here? That's the only question. The trade with the boar doesn't really bother me that much. I'm just figuring out how big of a risk can I want to make here. I guess I can take the risk here. Yeah. Oh, there was actually one reason to. Okay, they left me the vigilance guy up. Well, I mean that does give them the option to cast spells on my turn without taxing effect. But yeah, one reason to not play the bland pre-combat was that I could draw from the locket one of my guild gates. So now I suppose now that I have a 5-drop here, it's gonna only hurt me if I draw one of my 1/1s. You know this. I have these 1/2s that get death touch by activation, so because I could have now just played the guild gate after activating the locket, so let's see if I get punished. Also, if I draw something like a 6-drop here, I will get punished as well. Can they double the power somehow? I'm just gonna do it like this. This doesn't have trample, so I'm just gonna gain 12 life by sacking this oligarch in here. It seems like they don't have anything, so I should be. They would have to actually block with the caretaker here now, and then this drool will be lethal. Well, after starting 0-2, this 3-2 match record does feel pretty good. Okay, now I have honestly a good starting hand that doesn't even have to draw anything specific to be good. Couple of 2-drops, a 3-drop, and now a 4-drop as well, and then the 4th mana. Okay, so now this has this ability, so neither of my 2-drops is particularly good, but I guess this Vigilance guy is fine. I mean, I can start trading 2 damage. Excuse me. I can start trading 2 damage here unless they have. Okay, though that was nice. Although my oligarch is gonna be a pretty nice one as well. So this has vigilance, so free attack. They can trade with it, of course. I get to 1/1 flyer. And well, I suppose. I kind of want to use the mana efficiently. But I could also do something weird here. I mean, because this is target creature with flying. I have a couple of other flyers. I could try to get some value out of this. Out of this activate triggered ability. But then again, my next turn will most likely be the just messenger. My turn 5 could be if I draw an untapped land at some point. You know, playing the Mangler and a 2-drop. I'm just trying to figure out if I should just simply play the, you know, mana efficient way here. Yeah. This makes every blocker. Yeah, I can't really block with it. Anything that has one power or one toughness isn't a good blocker against that thing, so I'm just trying to figure out. I mean, this is a 2-power flyer and the other options are 1-power guys, so yeah, fine. I'll waste the trigger here now. I mean, it's not completely wasted because if they have something like Hasty Guy, because I can boost this thing, but yeah. Nah. More of those. So it's gonna be a race then. Then we will race. Now it's gonna be the messenger, which I'm going to use to block any of their guys. Of course, they can have something. Well, that's a good one. They will make me be unable to block. So now I have to be in the on the defensive. I can remove that, gain some life. My guys don't have vigilance, so the Clamor Shaman, I have to kill it. And any single blocker from me won't be able to block, so maybe I'll just leave the 1-1. Attack with the 2-1 here. I'm gonna be playing, I mean, I guess I can choose to play two creatures or just a Carrion Imp. Well, the Carrion Imp can also block the Plague White. Maybe I'll do it so that I will leave the 1-1 to block the Claymore Shaman here. They could have some kind of removal. And I will play the Carrion Imp in here to gain some life. Make it so they can't return this with any kind of Raise Dead effect. And now I have three blockers. They can make one of them not block, but then I have still two blockers left to try to kill the Claymore Shaman, and I can take damage from these guys. And I can still double spell next turn. I don't imagine I want to kill any of these in particular. Okay, now they can just do that kind of an attack. So it means that I'm simply going to block. I guess I'm gonna just block there. It's not nice to lose the Imp here though. But I can't block these with my guys. I mean, one power, they don't block them. It's pretty embarrassing to block with my 4-power, 4-drop flyer. They are 2-mana, 2-1. But is it something I want to do? This is not a bad block because I get the 1-mana flyer myself. I will take 3 damage in here, and then I have here 5 power of flyers, so I guess I can just try to... Yeah, I'm gonna just, raise them here, because I do have these blockers. I can have the 1 Blake White here. Yeah, sure. This is also 2 damage to the controller, by the way. It's not really in a tight situation. For example, next turn, I can actually win. Let's see how likely they are gonna win here. They have here now, they have 7 power in here. So that means that unless they can also get additional power either by playing a haste creature or dealing somehow 2 damage, they could have a boost spell, a burn spell or something like that. But they do have to get rid of my blockers. So if I play these 2 blockers, it's gonna mean that one of them will be unable to block. One of them will be blocking. So if they remove the blocker, they still need to find a way to deal 2 additional damage. Otherwise, I will win next turn because I will make them. Yeah, I'm gonna want to attack with all of these guys because I have to consign to the pit. So this will do 6 damage and this will be the rest of the damage. And now I'm gonna just. Of course, I have to hope they don't have any discard stuff, but this should be good enough. I'm just not gonna. Okay, Riot and Menace. This can get haste. Is that? No, that's not enough. Is it though? I can jump block the 3-2. Yeah, this is not enough. They don't know about the consign to the pit, so I'm gonna. So who is not able to block? This Pegasus, right? So I'm gonna. Oh, wait a second. I have to block the 1-1. The thing that gives them blockers. Isn't that right? If I block the 2-2, this has Menace, by the way. Well, I can block the white here. Oh yeah, no, it's actually quite fine, of course. I mean, yeah, like I said, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 damage, and I have 9 here, so this should be good. I don't want to keep them there at blockers. I wouldn't be able to win in that case. Okay, let's see if they have 2 additional damage there. Oh man, completely missed. Oh. Let's see. No, I have still damage here enough. I mean, yeah, I didn't realize I get the flyer. But oh man, sorry about that. Yeah, that thing actually. I'm embarrassed now. This is so embarrassing. This has an ability beyond the afterlife too. I really just consider this is a 5-mana 3-2 with Afterlife 2, which wouldn't be that great. But I suppose if I did count everything correctly, that was the correct decision anyway. It's just sad that my decision 3 wasn't the correct one. Because I should have... I did realize that I can't kill this Afterlife guy, because they will get 2 blockers and my flyers won't be lethal then. But I didn't realize that I still have 8 power here when I make the block. I mean, the decision I made was correct. I had to take the risk that I have to discard this, because blocking this thing would just make me impossible. I only winning card would be the Ethereal Absolution in that stage. So discarding this wasn't so bad, but I really should have just counted all the damage I will be able to deal. So I must apologize for the stupid reasoning I made there, even though the play ended up being the correct one. Okay, I don't have a 2-drop. Yeah, I have a 7-drop, 6-drop, 4-drop, 4-drop. Sadly. Have to mulligan this. Opponent did mulligan 2, and this is a fine keep here. The only question is, which card do I not keep? I mean, I have 1 and 2 drops in here. But these flyers are just, you know, pretty nice. I guess it's gonna be the messenger still, because I do wanna play my 1 and 2 drops, but I think the grasping tool is just better than the messenger, so that makes sense. The reason I want to play this, because if they have some aggressive deck, I want to be able to, you know, trade some damage. I want to have enough time to get my grasping tool into play. The other consideration in this hand would have been the Twilight Panther. By the way, it's fine. I could have played this Panther turn 1, but I didn't, so I guess I get rid of my tapped land here, and next turn I can play double spell here, this 1 to 1 and 2 drops, so... Okay, this can't be blocked by defenders if they activate it. Rakdos. Well, that's a good one. I'm gonna make the trade here, right? I mean, I can gain 2 life, but... Well, then again, this Enforcer will be able to... Okay, I can raise here a bit, because this is basically trading 2 damage here. Because they are not going to be able to block. Both dealt 2 damage, but I get to gain 2 life here. So that's it. That's the relevant part in here. So, like this. And now I can block the Artist with my Ores of Enforcer. So this actually was a reasonable thing to do. And dropping the 4th land wasn't definitely a bad one, because now I should be in a decent shape whether I draw a land or a spell. Of course I do have expensive spells like 5 and 6 drops and 1 7 drop, but those are reasonable spells, so I don't really mind that much drawing one of them. But most likely I will draw either a land, which will be good for the following turn, or then I draw a spell that I'm likely to be able to cast. So they can sacrifice in their upkeep, and the Footlight Fiend. I mean, I guess I'm gonna trade with my Death Toucher. The Fiend will ping the flyer at some point, but I mean, so be it. I mean, I already traded with this card, and this 1-1 flyer is just a bonus here. Well, the Demise is something I could actually use against the Fiend, because this Fiend is kind of efficiently blocking my ground guys. If I kill these and they don't have anything, they don't have a good block, and I will actually be able to deal some damage here. So this might sound weird, but I think this makes sense, because this exile, so the trigger won't happen unless they have something, but we'll see. They are pausing because this has an activated ability they could activate, so it doesn't mean that they necessarily are holding a spell that they can play. This is actually just one yeah, okay, this was a, like, I could have considered that they can have, you know, this spectacle cards, so now they get the free attack with this thing, and they may get some. Okay, they have something here. Maybe Blade Brand. Okay, well, they're still to rage, so they, of course they draw a card, but they won't get any spectacle trigger now. They just didn't want me to gain life with this guy, I suppose. Well, I mean, that was also, they maybe wanted to play the Blade Brand anyway, so they could get some value out of the Death Touch ability too. Okay, them skewering my 1-2 is not really gonna be a big deal. I have a 3-3 flyer in here coming up too, so that was more than acceptable. Okay, that's a good one, but not when they don't have really any kind of board presence. It's not so easy to race with that card, especially now that I did draw the fifth land for my Thrill here. So that's only draining one per turn, so they need something to, they need to deal with my guys, and yeah, this is probably gonna be over next turn. Or maybe they can activate this, but that's just a temporary measure. Okay, so wow, was that like win number 4 or 5 even? Don't even recall it anymore. Okay, I started 0-2 and now I am at 5-2, and I didn't even get to cast so far the Ethereal Absolution more than in one game, so that's not the reason I've been winning. I mean, I take it. Okay, so now this is a good hand. So I have a 2-drop, and I have a 3-drop, and I have the Absolution in here, and I have the Locket to be quite likely able to cast it at some point. I only need to like draw 2 more lands at some point in the game, and the opponent doesn't have any early pressure here, so this could be my 6th win. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Scorch Mark is of course good against these Afterlife guys. So they are gonna play a 3. Okay, that can be annoying, but at least now I get the Death Toucher, so this is gonna block anything they might have. Okay, so if I play the Locket, I can't do anything else, but if I play the Locket, I can play the Ethereal Absolution next turn. Oh, there's nothing to. The guys are exiled, so I mean, of course, the passive effect is very strong too. But I'm just thinking that now I can play a Spire Mangler or the Grotesk Demise, and next turn I can play the Locket and one of them, because I do have the land here. So I think I'll still do that. This can't be blocked by tokens. Doesn't matter. I will block it with the Death Toucher here. Yeah, they are gonna. Oh, that's very good with the Rhythm of the Wild. That is very good. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna demise this guy now that it lost the counter. Still, they get value of this card, of course. But I may just have to. Well. Spire Mangler, if they attack with this, that's actually gonna be good. Because I have the. This can block it and kill it. Oh, 2 of those. Well, that's something. That is something indeed. At least they did attack with it, so there's something. But yeah, that's pretty nice having those kind of cards there. But of course, what is nice is that I have this, let's say, somewhat sick of a card. They can remove the counter from themselves. Yeah, they can. So it's not really that over, but it's still, of course, a lot better. Yeah, but the Rhythm of the Wild is pretty nice. All the one toughness guys, they now get to survive thanks to the Rhythm here. But my guys are quite big too, so it's relevant. So I have now 7, 8, no, 6, 6, 7, no, yeah, I do have 8 mana here. Now it's not so hard to make some calculations, but actually, there are creatures I can. Yeah, a lot of creatures. So let's. And this is gonna give me the white mana. Yep. Everything is fine. Well, any creature is gonna be good, and this is gonna even have a death touch, and it's gonna be a 3/3, so it can't be killed by that thing. So. And this gets menace, right? Yeah. Let's see how it's gonna be. Savage Smash. Okay, then I can't. That was a good one, by the way. At least they can't attack with the Crusher, so they can't deal with the 6 damage, because I can block it with the. Okay. So let's get rid of that thing. This will be a 2/2 flyer. They don't have any card in their hand, so. I mean, this was a mistake, I think. That ability would have been pretty relevant there. But yeah, I'll take it, because now I can play my Death Toucher, and again, there's enough food for the Absolution that, yeah, it's just a sick card. They had the Rhythm there, but I mean, I'm still winning this game. This is gonna get +3/+3, but it has the Death Touch, so it's not gonna be good enough for them. It's so annoying to play against this. I have played against this, and it's so annoying. I can double block it, and they can't even kill both of the guys, because it has only 4 power in here. So, yeah. The Death Touch makes sure it's gonna die. They can only kill one of these, and well, that's not great for them. So now I have the card draw possibility as well as this, so let's draw the cards. No, wrong. Wrong one. So, like this. And, of course, going to rather make a token. This can boost how many times? It can even boost twice, actually, so. I could take some damage. Alright, the safe play is to actually. But then again, I will have a next turn. No, I will have only 9 mana, so I can't really activate this twice and play the Enforcer. Yeah, next turn I can activate this twice to make the token. Yeah, definitely I will play the Enforcer now. Next turn I can still, yeah, use this twice, so it's okay. Okay, at this game I won because of the Absolution. But hey, it's the second game where I drew it, so maybe it's fair that I see it. After playing so many games where I didn't see it. Yeah, I'm gonna just, of course, make all the trades here. They even have to pump it once to not just, you know, lose their guys for nothing. Okay, that's fine. I mean, I'm not gonna run out of food here. The Absolution will create tokens here to a turn, so this is just an unfair card. Such an unfair card. So let's see, mana is, that is 9, so I can still use this Absolution here. It does get to draw some, you know, impactful cards, but it just doesn't do anything against the Absolution. This is such a sick card. Okay, so So I did start 0-2, and then I have won 6 games straight. I said that after I won my first game, that I guess I go 7 wins now. I wasn't quite serious, but hey, now there's a good chance to go to 7 wins, so that would be quite fun indeed. Okay, I have my absolution here. Only 2 lands, but I do have 2 drops. I can draw a card with this thing, so I'm gonna keep it. Hopefully I don't get stuck on mana, because this 5 drop is also a long way coming, but I mean, there's a long way to till I get to cast it. But I have the absolution in my hand, so I'm gonna keep it. And of course these 2 drops I can play with the mana I have available. It makes the difference here. Okay, that's good. Land. Land is very nice. I'll play the 2-power guy because I'd rather try to connect a couple of times with the 2-power guy than with just the 1-power guy. And I guess I'm gonna trade with most of the 2 drops with this thing because I will get the 1-1 flyer. And they didn't even have anything. So they can now play a 1-mana spell only. So they can't really have any. The quench is in this format, but it doesn't do anything when I have the tithe taker and they have only 2 mana. And Concordia Pegasus, alright, so. Well, that's gonna mean that I'm not gonna attack. I'm not gonna even bluff attack because I just want to block this thing, I suppose. Has defender and loses flying. So it has defender now. Fine. Well, I don't have anything to play. Even nothing in the graveyard, but I think I will use the consume when I get the 4th mana. Opponent is actually missing land drops. But so am I. But I mean, I kept the 2 land drops, so getting the 3rd is fine. Because now if I draw a land, I have 2 4 drops I can play, so I shouldn't be in. Okay, and they have to go to discard in there. Well, at least I get punished here by. Well, I mean, I'm not so sure if it's punished, but get the 7 drop here is quite funny. Alright, I think it's gonna be time to exile the card and try to get the land here, because I will have drops to make here anyway, so it's not gonna be that great to leave the consume up. Of course they can have something that I would have wanted to remove, but I think the 3-2 flyer will help quite a bit. Then I will have the 3-3 flyer, and then I'll at some point. Oh, high alert. Well, now this is gonna be a 3 power thing. But the Griffin is still going to brawl with it. Locket is a mana source, but if I cast that next turn I can't do anything else, so I'd rather just try to find the land. And if I don't, at least I get to play the Syndicate Messengers, which I couldn't do if I play the Locket. Anyway, it's all about if they don't have an answer to the Absolution or not. Okay, now attacking costs mana. Well, I mean, I guess I could still attack and play the Enforcer, because this 2-3 doesn't really do anything against their 1. Well, actually it is a 2, it's a 3-3. So sure, I will do it like this. Maybe they will trade. They did not. Okay, so all I need is the lands now. A couple of trolls and the absolution will be backbreaking if okay, there wasn't land. Okay, 2 of the first cards weren't lands. I'm happy about that. And that mill. Okay, that got killed, fine. Still no land. 4 cards milled, only 1 of them was land, and I have a couple of lands waiting for. Okay, I'm supposed to draw land at some point. This is gonna be a 4-4. It can attack, right? Yeah, that's right. But I do have a Death Touch guy. Actually 2, in fact, although this requires mana. They get to draw cards. Okay, they are gonna now get stuff going on. I need to draw the land. Even if it's a guild gate, I don't mind. Just a land. Okay, thank you. Because I still have the Panther I can play, and then the Trolls will... Now I will have plays for the rest of the game. So it's more like... Do they have better plays? Oh, that's a good one. They can attack with the Flyer. It's gonna get... +3, +3. Okay, they did that kind of a move. They are gonna go for the aggressor. They're gonna deal 8 damage. No, 9 damage here. But, I can't prevent here actually 9 by attacking the Pegasus here. Might be something I wanna do. It doesn't do much against the Pegasus here. Yeah, sure. Because I should be having the late game with the Absolution here, definitely. And, I could start attacking with my ground guys now. I guess the Twilight Panther can attack because I won't be having the mana. I don't mind the trade to either of these guys. Because even if they trade with their spirits here, I have the Noxious Crudion to play. So this is what I'm gonna do. I suppose they're gonna take just 1 damage, and then I can play this. Oh, that's a nice one. That's gonna be a 5 damage dealer. I need the Absolution. At least now they don't have any kind of a... This is unblockable and it's nice with this high alert. So if they don't have answer for this thing, but blue-white can have, but at least they have no counterspell mana here. So I'm definitely gonna jam the Absolution here now. And I have pretty good attacks because my guys are big and their guys are not. I can actually attack with... Everyone but, well, I'm gonna attack with this. No, this is a 4-4. Well, basically a 4-4. So I can't actually, I kind of missed it. So do I want to attack with my Death Toucher? It would just trade with the Wall of Lost Thoughts. Well, I mean, Flyers are attacking regardless. I mean, if they trade with it, I get a 2-2 Flyer. Fine. And then I can block the Wall of Lost Thoughts with a Tithe Taker. I can play block the Forbidden Spirit with the Panther. I can't block this thing. I can't block this thing when my Flyers are attacking. So yes, this makes sense. And of course, I am at 22. I'm not going to die right away. But problem is that if they can deal with the Absolution, well, then it's not going to be so easy. Because this Arbiter is going to do short work of me. Another one of these. This is actually gonna be a pretty nice. I at least have this life gain in here. And so they are not gonna win next turn, but that's pretty sweet stuff they have going on in there. So let's now see. Okay, well, let's not see. I suppose I think I had to win there, by the way. But they didn't know it because I had to. But let's see, I have these Flyers, they can block. Even if they jump, they are gonna drop to 2, and this Troll will be lethal. Okay, so this indeed. Indeed, the Sick Rare did end up mattering in there. Well, in one of the earlier games, and then in these two late games too. So it was an 0-2 into 7-2. So let's enjoy that. Alright, that was the first Ravnica Allegiance draft. So my plan is that I'm going to play like maybe once a day these things. So I will upload one of these drafts a day, and of course also one Zendikar Rising traditional draft per day. So you will see like maybe 5 or 6 of these drafts in the next week. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.